In this video, we take a look at the top 5 features coming your way in SAP Analytics Cloud. These include
seamless planning integration with SAP Datasphere, Compass probability simulation, video data stories, Just Ask enhancements, and Job Monitor multi-action support.
Hi, my name is Orla Cullen, and these are your What's New updates for Q1 2025. A much anticipated item for this quarter is the introduction of seamless planning, a new approach to the planning integration between SAP Analytics Cloud and SAP Datasphere. With seamless planning, you can now store the SAP Analytics Cloud model's data, fact and master data, directly in SAP Datasphere, reducing the data footprint and making it available for real-time consumption, additional processing, and extensibility scenarios using SAP Datasphere's capabilities.
So here we are building a new model in SAP Analytics Cloud. We are prompted to choose the data storage location and we select SAP Datasphere and the space we wish to access. I upload a flat file to create my model. In my model, we can now choose to expose the fact data of the model in Data Builder within SAP Datasphere. We are providing a technical name and a business name, and we do the same thing for the new product public dimension table. We now create a simple planning application in which we create a new product to plan, and we add this to the product hierarchy. We then enter some data, publish, and we see what it looks like in SAP Datasphere. In SAP Datasphere, we see the generated tables based on our actions in SAP Analytics Cloud, and we can combine that with actual data and original master data that we have in SAP Datasphere. We can look at the analytical model sitting on top of that model and also look at the dependency view to see how the analytical model is compiled. Finally, we can put an SAP Analytics Cloud story on top of the analytical model, which will always have live plan versus actual comparison.
We are very excited to announce the arrival of SAP Analytics Cloud Compass, which provides Monte Carlo simulation capabilities with a business user-friendly interface. This enables non-technical users to perform real-time multivariate analysis without prior IT setup or advanced statistics skills.
You can trigger a new Compass simulation via the toolbar or directly from a dashboard. Today we will start from a dashboard. First we see a simplified profit and loss structure with the different revenue and expenses aggregated up to the operating income. If things are not going as planned this quarter for some of the drivers, we can trigger a Compass simulation directly off a dashboard to explore. The drivers are automatically detected, and we can directly simulate a range of uncertainty for gross revenue to simulate the impact of possible trends and new deals. We can also simulate a range of fluctuations for direct material. We can now run the simulation and choose between preview, medium, or high precision, which is a choice between 1,000, 10,000, or 100,000 calculation iterations. In this scenario, we choose the medium precision. In the background, 10,000 calculations of the operating income will be performed, with each calculation sampling a random value for the driver within a range you have specified. The result will be sorted into a graph, and you can easily see the range of probable outcomes for the operating income. You can also see the boundaries between the pessimistic, realistic, and optimistic cases, with the value boundaries clearly displayed again at the bottom. You can open the case settings to change the name, color, and percentage divisions for these cases. The current budget plan, which is a baseline, is also displayed on the graph, and you can see here it is still within the realistic range. But there is a much higher chance of achieving a value below it rather than a value above it. You can also drag a slider to explore the chances of achieving the individual value types or type them in, for example here, $100 million, to understand the likelihood of achieving them. You can also save a simulation to show your colleagues or come back to it at a later point in time. Once saved, you can create multiple scenarios to compare the results. For example, I will make a copy of the current one to simulate the scenario where I will secure deals in both the EU and US, and also salvage some of the customer trends in Asia by spending more on marketing and customer services. You can run another simulation again and compare the scenario results. In this way, a common language of risk analysis between different departments can be created in a coordinated simulation environment.
Another very exciting feature this quarter is the addition of the video data story. This feature will allow business users to design and create a short form video directly inside SAP Analytics Cloud without any video editing expertise.
We open a story with optimized design experience with the video data story toggled on. Users will be able to select and add a chart from their story to a video data story. A new design panel will then open at the bottom of the screen, and the user can continue to select more charts and KPIs to add to their video data story. In our initial release, we support bar charts, pie charts, line charts, and also numeric charts. Users can easily drag and drop charts to arrange the sequence to their liking. We can also drill into individual charts and add the results to the preview panel. In this scenario, where we have relationships between the charts, we can also add transition effects. We can also change the rotation from landscape to portrait, and we can add an opening title to make it more meaningful for our audience. I can also change the background image, and within SAC, we will provide a pre-delivered list of background images to get you started, or you can choose one of your own. You can also select background music from a delivered list. Once the design of your video data story is complete, you can save it as a new artifact in the file repository. The video story can then be edited or shared with colleagues.
Just Ask has been a popular feature in SAP Analytics Cloud. And in this release, we add several new features, including support for currency conversion in acquired data models, displaying a limited number of data points in the bar charts, and leveraging SAP HANA Cloud Vector Engine. But let's take a closer look at the currency conversion.
First, we select an acquired data model with amounts in multiple currencies. This model has a currency conversion variable. The variable will set the default currency, and we select Brazilian as our default. If we ask for sales without specifying a currency, we return the result in Brazilian real. If we include the currency code in the question like JPY, we get a result in Japanese yen. As long as a valid ISO currency code is provided, conversion is performed on the fly and does not require a conversion measure to be defined in the model. On the other hand, if we ask sales in British pounds, British pounds is not a currency. This question requires a currency conversion measure to be defined in the model. Finally, if we need results in local currencies, we can leverage a currency conversion measure defined in the model. The result is automatically broken down by the dimension and the currency property. In this example, the country dimension. Currency conversion can, of course, be combined with other elements in the question. For instance, to compare actual to forecast. If we drill to the European Union, we see sales in Denmark in Danish krona, in Belgium in euros, in Sweden in Swedish krona, and in Poland in zloty.
Last, but by no means least, in this release, we introduced the Job Monitor, which will make it much easier for business users and administrators alike to gain insights about the status of background jobs and overall processes. Let's take a look.
I access the Job Monitor from the homepage by going to System and then Job Monitor. In the Job Monitor, the first thing I see is a list of the main jobs, that is data actions and multi-actions run over the past 7 days. I can also go directly to multi-actions, where I see two multi-actions that have run in the last week. Much like data actions, I have the ability to select the multi-action and see the individual steps. In this case, the data actions within the multi-actions that have been executed and the execution history and timing and duration of those jobs. If I go back to my main jobs, you'll see that I have concisely the list of all data actions and multi-actions. But then within that, if I were to select all jobs, what I see is the run history of the data action and multi-actions, including the data actions that are nested within the multi-action. We also have very rich filtering capabilities. By default, we show the last 7 days of jobs. But I have a number of filter capabilities based on time ranges. We can also filter on job status and job duration, so I can look at individual second ranges, in this case, 15 to 30 seconds, and I'll see all the jobs that ran in that window. Finally, there are multiple ways to get to the Job Monitor, via the Data Action application and the Multi-Action application. And in either case, if I click that button, I'm taken to the relevant subset of jobs.
Thank you for joining us to learn about some of the top features coming in the Q1 2025 release cycle of SAP Analytics Cloud. Check out the video description for more links to resources about this quarter's updates. Also remember to leave a like on this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date with all things SAP Analytics Cloud. Thank you. Thanks again. See you next time.